guys, what is up? My name is Kat. I'm a registered dietitian and I upload weekly videos on intentional and mindful eating, as well as sharing my minimalist approaches to nutrition and nutrition coaching without cluttering rules and restrictions. So today we are talking about having a black or white mindset when it comes to nutrition and how I see that happen a lot in perfectionists. And this is something that I have struggled with in the past so many times. So let's just go ahead and get started. Having a black or white mindset is something that I see a lot in yo-yo dieters. So people who are on this cycle of dieting and then getting off diets and gaining weight and losing weight and gaining weight and losing weight, it's just this constant cycle. It's not helpful for the body. It's actually really stressful for the body and not healthy. And so one of my biggest focuses as a nutrition coach is really dialing into the sustainable habits that are going to serve you and serve you long term. And one thing that I see in a lot of yo-yo dieters who come to me, and something that I have struggled with in the past before, is having this black or white thinking when it comes to food. So that doesn't just mean having this black or white thinking of food itself and thinking that one food is inherently good or inherently bad, but really in the practices and how we interact with food. So it's important to see that even if you might not identify yourself as a perfectionist, how much that some of the perfectionistic tendencies can kind of show itself up or manifest in nutrition changes. One way that it shows up or manifests is someone is having a great day, they had a good morning of nutrition intake, and something happened. Life happens essentially, and they just have something that was not on their nutrition plan, doesn't fit with their goals, and then there's some guilt and shame surrounding that comes in, which then leads to some negative self-talk. And at that point, it's just kind of a downhill cycle from there of just having more of whatever that food was. It doesn't matter if everything else was going right, if they were seeing all of these great benefits and changes already, just that one thing happened. And so now everything is just a disaster. So some people can look at that and say that person is just being negative, but in reality, just saying that that person is negative doesn't get to the root of the problem. It doesn't get to that perfectionism and that standard that that person holds for themselves. So it's not to say that all negative people are perfectionists, but a lot of perfectionists, it's really easy for them to turn to negativity, especially on themselves, if not necessarily projecting it onto other people. So it's important to acknowledge it, to recognize it, in order for you to move past it, to stop it from essentially holding you back, because perfectionism, it's always going to be something that's going to hold you back. It's not something that's going to move you forward at all, because we can never be perfect. We are human beings, and there is no way that we can hold ourselves to this perfect standard. And so if you are in this perfectionistic viewpoint cycle with your nutrition, you're never going to get closer to your goals. You might get a little bit closer, but then you'll end up taking that same amount of steps back, sometimes even more. So that's not to say that we shouldn't hold ourselves to high standards. Again, it's good to have goals and to really strive to reach better versions of ourselves. But what I am saying is that failures should never define you. In reality, anybody who has achieved anything worth anything is they got there by failures. They got there through failing. And you might have heard in the whole like startup community, there's this quote or the saying of fail fast, fail hard. While it's not really something related to nutrition, it's related to everyday life. And as I've said before, how you do life is how you do nutrition. Nutrition coaching is so much more than just telling you to eat these foods and to not eat these foods, to give you a template or a meal plan. It goes so much deeper than that. And really, how you do food is also the reverse of how you do life. And there are certain times in your life whenever food is a little bit more challenging, but ultimately, generally, how you do life is how you approach food. And so it's really helpful to kind of work through and remove that all or nothing perfectionist mindset in other areas of your life whenever you are trying to make these nutrition changes, or at least try to recognize them and work through them. So one thing that really helped me when I was in school and just trying to have these perfect grades and just have really unrealistic expectations for myself was to remember to take a step back and kind of zoom out. Imagine looking at the entire world and realizing how whatever I'm trying to do that I'm trying to get perfect, in the grand scheme of things, it literally means nothing. Like, it is so tiny. It doesn't have an impact on the grand scheme of things. And that was kind of helpful to me to just like let it go and release it and realize that I can still put out work. I can still do something not to as high as expectations as I would want them. And it's still okay. The world is not going to end and it's fine. So when it's related to nutrition, if you have some kind of self-perceived failure or mistake, you can just see that as a blip on the radar, not have it produce any guilt or shame, and just keep on going. Another thing that really helps is if you have a sheet of paper and on the left side, you write down kind of those thoughts or those feelings that you're having, and then on the other side to write down the actual truths or the data of what is actually true. Is it really going to make an impact long term? And that can kind of help ground you whenever you are feeling those overwhelming feelings of not being able to live up to your expectations of being perfect, because you are a human. And one thing that I really try to make sure that my clients know whenever I'm working with them doing nutrition coaching is that I never expect any level of perfectionism with them. They might have a perfect week a couple times or a perfect month, whatever. And yes, I'm going to celebrate with them, but I'm going to celebrate with them more if they have some kind of struggle and they had like reached out to me and worked through that game plan in order to not have it derail them. You know, that's more important, is going through the challenges and not just relying on being perfect. Because in reality, life is always going to show up. And if you're doing nutrition coaching only whenever your life is super free and easy, whenever that is, it's going to be harder to implement. And you're not going to be able to implement whenever life gets more challenging. So that is one thing that I encourage people to do, is reach out whenever life is kind of crazy, just so you know how to roll with whatever life throws at you. And if anything, whenever life slows down a little bit, it'll be easier. All right. So as I mentioned before, being a perfectionist was something that I struggled with a lot when I was in college and just growing up. But I don't think it's ever something that anybody can 100% get rid of, but it is something that I do believe that we can get better at recognizing it, acknowledging it. It's something that you can arm yourself with some tools and activities that you're able to manage it in a better and healthier way. So if you have experienced any black or white thinking when it comes to nutrition or any perfectionism around that, I would love to hear your thoughts and continue the conversation. So let me know in the comments down below. And if you like this video, found it helpful at all, please go ahead and subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. So that's all. All right. Bye, guys.